Our desire is to extend a gracious and inclusive welcome to all of you. For now, let's put together and leave our differences and instead celebrate what brings us together. Respected Principal, Reverend Father Jolly Andrew CMI, Director Self-Financing Section, Reverend Father Wilson Tharail CMI, Coordinator Dr. Vivekanand Sir, HOD, Computer Science Department, Ms. Viji Vishwanathan, dear colleagues and my dear students, warm greetings. It's indeed a proud moment to cordially welcome you all to the celebration of Computer Literacy Week organized by the Department of Computer Science, Christ College, Autonomous Irinalakuda. To begin with, we have got an interesting session on machine learning. Before we get into the session, I would like to welcome our dear Principal Dr. Jolly Andrew CMI in his absence. Now, I gladly welcome Father Wilson Tharail, Director of Self-Financing Section, to formally inaugurate and bless our event. Wilson Acha, please.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, Acha. Welcome.
We already finished our morning prayer. Okay, thank you. With the prayer, we are beginning. Dear respected head of the department, Viji Miss, and my dear teachers, students, those who are participating in this meeting, welcome to you. At the same time, I'm congratulating this department because it's a great opportunity and at the same time, a good step, what you are doing. I congratulate you. You know, this world is now very much dependent upon the computer, internet, and everything. That is, computer-based thinking is already started and we are moving. But at the same time, many of us, including myself, I shall say, I am very much poor in literate in this field. But you can do something for these people, new generation and the old generation. What can we do with this literacy of our own computer learning? And you are already prepared a lot of, I think, 1 week program. That's why I'm wondering, how can you conduct these things 1 week? But at the same time, I am always appreciating you. I appreciate your ability. Our students are very good. They're ready to do anything. They know what is the future of their own life and others' life. Everything is okay. That's why you're preparing all these things. One thing I am mentioning, what you have, you please give to others. That is virtue. Our Christ College, our students have a lot of knowledge. Our teachers have a lot of knowledge. But try to give to others. Yesterday, your head of the department, Viji Miss, already told me one idea. I very much appreciate here because I conducted this one in my Christ Vidyanikethan school. After the school time, we already opened the computer center for the people. I remembering at the same time yesterday, Viji Miss already told me, Father, how can we utilize our own facilities to the people after the class time? And I congratulated her idea because I already practiced there in that Christ Vidyanikethan. But
Father, acha mute hai.
The teachers are still thinking about the social commitment of our own qualities and everything. And that's why I appreciate you. With that mind, you proceed. And what you have, you give to others also. That is a great virtue. That is the sign of Christ College. I appreciate all the teachers, students, and the faculty members, everybody. Congratulate you. God bless you. You proceed with God's these words. I inaugurate this function. Always God is with you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Father, for the pleasing words. And actually, it's a very big encouragement for our whole department. Thank you, Father. Now, I pleasantly welcome our IQAC coordinator, Dr. Robinson, sir, to say a few words. We would like to hear from you, sir. Please.
Thank you, Sini. Respected director of the college, Father Wilson Tarail, head of the department, Viji Vishwanathan, faculties of computer science department, and students from Christ College and also from various other colleges. ഈ ഇന്നത്തെ ടോക്ക് അറേഞ്ച് ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്നത് ഞാൻ മനസ്സിലാക്കുന്നത് മെഷീൻ ലേണിംഗ് എന്നുള്ള ഒരു സബ്ജക്റ്റിനെ സംബന്ധിച്ചാണ്. കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ ലിറ്ററസി വാരാചരണത്തോടനുബന്ധിച്ച് നടത്തുന്ന ഈ മെഷീൻ ലേണിംഗ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഈ ടോക്ക് സത്യത്തിൽ എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നു കോളേജിലുള്ള എല്ലാവരും കേൾക്കേണ്ടതാണ്, എല്ലാവരും അതിൽ പാർട്ടിസിപ്പേറ്റ് ചെയ്യേണ്ടതാണ്. എന്തുകൊണ്ടെന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ ലിറ്ററസി ഏറ്റവും കൂടുതൽ ആവശ്യം വരുന്ന ഒരു കാലഘട്ടത്തിലാണ് നമ്മൾ ജീവിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നത്. ഇനി ഇവിടുന്ന് അങ്ങോട്ടുള്ള കാലങ്ങളിൽ ഏറ്റവും കൂടുതൽ അത് ഇല്ലാതെ നമുക്ക് ജീവിക്കാൻ സാധിക്കില്ല. ഇപ്പൊ തന്നെ നമുക്ക് ജീവിക്കാൻ പറ്റുന്നില്ല, ഇനി ഇവിടുന്ന് അങ്ങോട്ട് ഒട്ടും തന്നെ സാധിക്കില്ല. ചെറിയൊരു എക്സാമ്പിൾ പറയുകയാണെങ്കിൽ, ICT എനേബിൾഡ് ടീച്ചിങ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് കോളേജിലെ ടീച്ചേഴ്സിന് ഒരു അഡീഷണൽ കാര്യമായിരുന്നു ഒരു 3 വർഷം മുമ്പ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ 4 വർഷം മുമ്പ് വരെ. ഒരു എക്സ്ട്രാ ക്വാളിറ്റി ആയിട്ട് ചേർത്തിരുന്ന ഒരു കാര്യമാണ് അത്. ഇന്ന് അത് തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും എസെൻഷ്യൽ ഒരു ആക്ടിവിറ്റി അല്ലെങ്കിൽ എസെൻഷ്യൽ കേപ്പബിലിറ്റി ആയിട്ട് മാറിക്കൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയാണ്. അപ്പൊ ഈ അവസരത്തിലാണ് നമ്മൾ കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ ലിറ്ററസി എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു വീക്ക് തന്നെ നമ്മൾ അതിനുവേണ്ടി മാറ്റിവെക്കുന്നത്. എന്തായിരിക്കണം നമ്മൾ കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ ലിറ്ററസി വീക്കിൽ നമ്മൾ ചെയ്യേണ്ടത്? തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും ഉദ്ഘാടന പ്രസംഗത്തിൽ വിൽസൺ അച്ഛൻ സൂചിപ്പിച്ചതുപോലെ അത് എല്ലാവർക്കും ഉള്ള ഒരു എഡ്യൂക്കേഷൻ ആയിരിക്കണം, ICT എഡ്യൂക്കേഷൻ ആയിരിക്കണം. ടീച്ചേഴ്സിന് മാത്രമല്ല, കുട്ടികൾക്ക് മാത്രമല്ല, നമ്മുടെ സറൗണ്ടിങ്സിലുള്ള എല്ലാവരെയും നമ്മൾ ഇത്തരം കാര്യങ്ങൾ നമ്മൾ പഠിപ്പിക്കേണ്ടതുണ്ട്. ഇത്തരം കാര്യങ്ങൾ പഠിപ്പിക്കുന്നതിൽ കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ സയൻസ് ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റ് എന്നും മുന്നിൽ തന്നെയാണ് എന്ന് നമുക്കറിയാം. കോളേജിലുള്ള എല്ലാ ഫസ്റ്റ് ഇയർ വിദ്യാർത്ഥികൾക്കും വേണ്ടി ICT എഡ്യൂക്കേഷൻ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ട് ഒരു ബേസിക് കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ ലിറ്ററസിയുടെ ഒരു ഫൗണ്ടേഷൻ കോഴ്സ് ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റ് നടത്തുന്നുണ്ട്. മറ്റനേകം പ്രോഗ്രാംസിനോടൊപ്പം തന്നെ ഇത്തരം കാര്യങ്ങളും നടത്തുന്നുണ്ട്. തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും ക്രൈസ്റ്റ് കോളേജിലെ കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ സയൻസ് ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റിന് ഇതിനേക്കാൾ അപ്പുറം ചെയ്യാൻ സാധിക്കുമെന്ന് മനസ്സിലാക്കുന്നു. ഈ ICT വീക്കിനോടനുബന്ധിച്ച്, കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ ലിറ്ററസി വീക്കിനോടനുബന്ധിച്ച് നടത്തുന്ന എല്ലാ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങൾക്കും എല്ലാവിധ ആശംസകളും നേർന്നുകൊണ്ട് നിർത്തുന്നു. താങ്ക് യു.
Thank you so much, sir, for the warming felicitation. Now let's waste no time and quicken ourselves to hear from our speaker, Dr. Ramya. Prior to the session, let me just brief up our resource person, Dr. Ramya K. Shashi, with immense honor. She graduated from IHRD Punyar and completed her post-graduation from Kerala University. She pursued her doctorate from NIT Calicut. She has about 9 years of great teaching experience. Her areas of interest include image processing, data science, machine learning, big data, and IoT. She has served as the head of department in different colleges and also have rendered her contributions as a research guide. She have also played vital role in different funded projects. Currently, ma'am is working as the head of the computer science department in our sister institution, Christ College of Engineering, Irinjalakuda. On behalf of Christ College and all who gathered here, I would like to genuinely welcome you, ma'am. Ma'am, please. Now the session is all yours.
Thank you, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Okay. From the bottom of my heart, I thank the management of Christ College and the Department of Computer Science for giving the opportunity. And I also congratulate the department for arranging a week long program for celebrating the Computer Science Literacy Week. I know Sini ma'am personally came and talked about the webinar. She was so interested about the session. She sent a list of topics that is to be discussed. And thank you, madam, for that. And what I understand is that I'm mostly talking to first year students, okay? Machine learning is actually pure mathematics. And I don't know how far the first year students can understand the higher concepts of machine learning, but I will try my level best to make it very simple. I haven't included any equations by considering the first year student that I haven't included. If it is a final year students, okay, I can think about that. So the very basics of mathematics you have is of plus two level. Okay. So I'm trying to make it a very simple. Then can I share my screen, madam?
Yes, sure. Sure, ma'am. Sure.
Okay, ma'am, what about the voice? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, the voice is clear. But ma'am, if possible, can you just keep your lighting okay? It's a bit dark.
Yeah, I'm not planning to switch on my camera. Shall I off it?
Yeah, yeah, sure, ma'am. Yeah. No.
Okay.
It's up to you, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Ma'am, is that visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah,
video is clear, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. I think it is visible and I'm audible. Shall I start the session?
Yes, ma'am. All okay. Please.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
So the session is about machine learning, a beginner's guide. So let me introduce myself. I'm Dr. Ramya K. Shashi, Associate Professor and Head of Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Christ College of Engineering, Irinalakuda. I'm very near to your institution. Okay. Only a few meters difference between your institute and our institute. So let's move on to the topics. This is a plan for today's session. Initially, we will very briefly describe about the evolution of machine learning, AI, and deep learning. And we will in detail look at the applications of artificial intelligence. Okay, throughout the discussion, I will use the term artificial intelligence and machine learning. Okay, even though the session is about machine learning, which is a subset of AI, then we will have a look into the types of machine learning, then about deep learning. And as this is a beginner's guide, I can give some tips about how to learn, how to start learning machine learning. And we will conclude the session. If time permits, I will show you Google Colab, so that you can understand how to work on small projects. Okay. So here is the evolution of AI. Okay. And you know, computers was invented long back in 1940s, and researchers were talking about artificial intelligence in 1950s, 60s. Well, so nowadays everything is smart, okay, and the basic necessities of our life, okay, what we learned in school is food, clothing, and shelter.
Recording in progress.
Okay, food, clothing, and shelter were the basic necessities of life. Now we have added a new thing, smartphone into that. So what is the meaning of the term smartphone? Now everything is smart. Smart home, smart TV, smartphone. Okay, what do you mean by smart? It means it has intelligence. Okay, the term smart is added to any devices which have intelligence. A much higher intelligence. Normally we will look at some students, maybe some kids, and we were very smart boy, very smart girl. So higher level of intelligence they have. So all those devices which have intelligence, we call smart. Okay. So you might be wondering, what is the intelligence possessed by our smartphone? So initially we told AI, okay. But after 1980s, this AI became machine learning. So we can say using set theory, AI is a superset and machine learning is a subset of AI. And as an example, I can say AI mainly deals with like if else statements. You might be familiar with if else statements. Okay, there are some rule based decisions. So AI mostly deals with some initial set of AI based problems, deal with rule based solutions. For example, chess was based on rules, and rule based decisions can be taken. And in chess game, we can say an AI chess game. Okay, so when coming to machine learning, mathematics comes very seriously. Okay, so machine learning means based on the previous experiments or based on the previous data, new predictions can be made, judgments can be made. But after 2010, this AI and machine learning pave way for deep learning. So deep learning is much complicated than machine learning, and there systems are trained the way human beings think and take decisions. So it's an abstract model of machine learning. So we can see that these are all subsets. So maybe after 10 or 20 years, we can see after every 30, 40 years, something new will come. And definitely after 10 years, another set will come inside that. So that is about machine learning, AI, and deep learning. So we will start with some basic examples we use every day, okay, where AI is mostly used. So now I am going through some applications where we use daily so that you will get an idea. I think the students will get an idea about, these were intelligent systems. So Google search engine. The first example we are going to see, Google search engine. So for example, if I am searching distance, okay, you take your Google search engine and type distance. When as soon as we type distance, you will get a number of options: distance between two places, distance vector algorithm, okay. And Google knows better than our parents. Google knows us better than any person in the world. So what is going to be your search? Okay. So Google search engine uses artificial intelligence. Okay. Intelligence in the sense, it will give us a set of options. Okay. Google provides intelligence in all these applications. Google Map. So if you want to travel from one place to another, okay, from Irinalakuda to Kochi, Google will search through all the paths. It will analyze the traffic, gives you the shortest path to the destination. Then about Google Ads, personalized ads will be displayed based on your age, based on your gender, okay, based on your preference. Okay, normally whenever we use Google and move on to Facebook, the ads, whatever ads coming, no, they are mainly based on our preferences, how Google is learning all such things. Then coming to YouTube. So YouTube also provides some intelligence. It always learn about some preference, our preferences. Okay, the search. If you search for a movie, a Malayalam movie now, okay, next time, whenever you log into YouTube, okay, some interest. If you are always searching for Mohanlal movies, next time a new Mohanlal movie, they will display. So Google, through all these tools, they are applying intelligence and making it a preferable one for its customers. Okay. Another intelligence used by Google is Gmail. Okay, Gmail. It has auto complete email option. You might be very familiar with that. Then translate means Google always provide the best language translation. Okay. Translate means if you are writing something in Malayalam, can be translated to another language. So Google provides a set of languages, and it is possible for us to translate from one language to another. Okay, Google provides those services, and Google Chrome, Google News. Okay, they are customizing the requirements of the user based on previous experiments. So these are some Google products that provide intelligence, but mostly you won't be aware about the fact that we are using intelligence. So that's about the Google artificial intelligence. And the Google Assistant is another tool where intelligence is used most. So how many of you are familiar with Google Assistant? Can someone tell me? I don't want to be the monotonic tone, just like a radio. So can someone tell me what is a Google Assistant? Any students? Can some student come forward and tell me what is Google Assistant? Anyone? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Okay.
Our students, please, someone come forward.
You might be familiar with the Google Assistant. Even our mobile smartphone have an assistant. Okay. Hello, Google. Say, hello, Google. You can train your phone to give us queries. You might be familiar with Alexa. Even Alexa, you might be familiar. We can talk. Just like a friend, we can talk. We can ask them to... Okay, play music. Okay, you can ask them to book a taxi. You can ask them to book a food that we prefer. Okay, assistant is just like a personal assistant. Okay, Google Assistant is like a personal assistant. Okay, and we can ask this assistant to do some favor for us. Okay, and the input to them. You need not give any hand-based inputs. You can talk to them and give inputs. It will understand and it will reply to us, or it will do some favor for us. That is Google Assistant. It is available in your smartphone as well as your computer is available. Okay. Now about Facebook AI. So these are some examples where AI is being used most. Okay, Facebook, then Google, they all are working on their products. Okay, so that they can present a better product to the customers. So these are some areas where Facebook AI is doing policing work. So we can find 7 use cases. So hate speech, terrorism, nudity, graphic violence, spam, suicides, and fake accounts. So Facebook, using their AI, using artificial intelligence, is trying to solve. So you know, Facebook was a social media that's being used by millions of people around the globe. Any signs of terrorism or any signs of hate speech, okay, they will identify it easily using AI. Okay, either they can test using some word searching. Okay, certain words they will count. Even if violence or terrorism in terms of graphic violence can also be identified by Facebook. So every day we used to read in newspapers about some accounts are being deleted by Twitter, some accounts are being deleted by Facebook, some accounts are being deleted by Instagram, because they keeps on working on these 7 items. Okay, using AI, it is not possible to appoint a single person to look at this. Okay, they will identify any of these 7 items using AI and finally make a decision based on a manual intervention. Okay. There are many other features that Facebook provides. Okay. But I'm talking about only very few cases where AI is being used. One is automatic image recognition. I don't know how many of you remember. You are very small kids, long back when, before 10 years, when I was using Facebook, okay, maybe in 2010, 11, 12 and all. So whenever we upload an image to Facebook, okay, they asked us to tag persons. Tag means, see, you can see a photo here, okay. Tag means if this friend is a person one, okay. Okay, this friend is... Facebook will ask us to tag that person. Okay, so it will identify the face, give the name. Okay, so it was like creating a database of face recognition. So every person used to tag the face of all the people in the photograph. Okay, that was a habit of many of the persons. So we too used to do that. So later, after 5 or 6 years, Facebook has built a very good face recognition database. Now, whenever your friend add a photo of you, Facebook will give a note like, Gary has added a photo, you might be in. Now, Facebook is identifying your photograph, okay? And it will send a notification. Should I tag it or not? Okay. So this is how Facebook automatic image recognition works now. So every photograph will be scanned using deep learning. And this image recognition software will recommend the name to us. So this is how image recognition works. And we are mostly discussing on applications of artificial intelligence. So far we discussed about some of the features of Google AI, Facebook AI. Okay, and there are a lot of other application. Why I'm saying about application is that you are very small children. Okay, you're first year students. So to learn machine learning, if I start with mathematics, I don't know how many of you would be able to understand and listen to it throughout the session. Okay, so instead I thought I will discuss about some application. So create an interest in some areas. So keep on reading on that area. Okay, identify the algorithms and read about or study about it further. Okay, so I will go through some other examples. Okay, see this. Smart farming. Okay. As people from Kerala, we might be very much interested about smart farming, irrigation, feeding animals, weed removing. Okay. We are using IoT. Okay. We are using robotics, etc. for doing farming. Okay. Now, instead of watering our plants more than the quantity what they really require, we can plant and give the exact quantity of water regularly. Okay, we have micro irrigation systems that uses artificial intelligence for smart farming. See the word smart. So smart means they are using some level of intelligence. So see how far AI is affecting our life. Okay, and robots are being used in factories. Okay, where factories where human find it very difficult to, okay, work throughout the day. We have a limited time, working hours, maybe 8 hours only we can work. But robots, they can work throughout the day. They don't need any food. They don't need any rest. So they can be used in factories. Okay. And places where it's very dangerous. Some places, see, in mining and all, it's very dangerous to send human being. You might have read many news very recently that certain mine explosions happened. Okay. So if robots are being used, that's actually providing a safety for human beings. Okay. Then about online shopping and advertising, online shopping. Okay. Now most of you might would be doing shopping online. In the online mode, you are purchasing mobile phones, everything using Flipkart, Amazon and all. So how would you purchase some items or consumables? See, you will initially search for an item. Okay. Later, whenever you log in, it will provide a list of similar items. Okay. They will, within few seconds, they will absorb. Okay. Flipkart or Amazon, they will collect our entire details, your preferences, your age, your gender, everything, and displays items. Okay. My son is only 3 years old. My son, I have a small kid. My son is 3 years old. So right from the birth of my son, okay, I used to buy things online. Okay, and now Flipkart knows better than me what all products are required by him. So initially, when he was a small boy, I used to buy diaper. Okay, used to buy some small things for him, some toys. Now they know how old is my son. Okay, initially they will ask, for whom are you buying? Okay, we will enter for son. His age? Okay, one. Now they know he is 3 years old and his games, the preferences of games have changed. Now Flipkart will show me toys your son may like. Okay, they know better than me. So, okay, these are based on online shopping and advertising is part of that. Okay, and sometimes we are pushed to buy that. Okay, if I try to search things, I won't reach there. But Flipkart, okay, it's giving us preferences. Like, so any online shopping site, they are using a good level of intelligence for that. Now, coming to autonomous car, some of you, can someone tell me an automatic car? You might be familiar with Tesla, Google car and all. Are you familiar?
Tesla.
Yes. Tesla is very good. Very good. Tesla. You might be familiar with the Tesla. Okay. So you need not drive. Tesla has introduced. Okay. You need not drive. Smart driving. Okay. Google has produced the same thing. So everything is going to be smarter and smarter in the future with the help of artificial intelligence. I told you, I will be using the term AI and machine learning interchangeably, but both are different. Both are different, but AI is a super class. Okay. So there are a lot of applications. Every day we are doing, we are going through those applications where AI is being used, but we are not aware about that. Okay. Then these are some other applications. Okay. And certain places where AI is used most is computer vision. So computer vision itself is a very large area. If I talk about computer vision, it will take another day to finish the computer vision. Computer vision mostly uses artificial intelligence. Okay, we will see about that later. Okay, expert system. Then about the gaming, speech recognition, hand recognition. So these are some of the applications of artificial intelligence. Some certain points are being repeated in some slides. Okay. Okay. So a day or two is not enough to completely explain the application, but we will see some very few examples. Okay, so another area is gameplay. Okay, so you people might be familiar with the gameplay last 2 years. Okay, you are in online mode and you all have mobile phone, and most probably you might be looking or you might be playing some games in between. Okay, so this area you might be familiar, and many games are based on artificial intelligence. And can anyone tell on one or two games where AI is being used? Can someone tell me one or two games that you might be familiar? Okay, maybe you can provide in the chat box, or you can unmute your mic and tell me some games. If I keep on talking, no, I don't know whether you people are listening. So shall I call some names? Amal Krishna, he meant. Okay, Amal Joe, are you there? Amal Joe, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Amal Joe, hello, Amal Joe. Amal Joe, evade ana veedu? Okay, Amal Joe, edengilum game okay, computer games okay, kalikkarundo? Edengilum AI based games ariyo? അറിയോ ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു എന്താണ് ആർട്ടിഫിഷ്യൽ ഇന്റലിജൻസ് ബേസ്ഡ് ഗെയിം?
എനിക്ക് അങ്ങനെ ചോദിച്ചാലും
ആർക്കെങ്കിലും പറയാൻ പറ്റുമോ? എനി വൺ യു ക്യാൻ ഈവൻ പ്രൊവൈഡ് ഇൻ ചാറ്റ് ബോക്സ്. മെനി ഗെയിംസ് ആർ ദേർ AI ബേസ്ഡ്. പിന്നെ ഓഗ്മെന്റഡ് റിയാലിറ്റി, വെർച്വൽ റിയാലിറ്റി based games are there. Yeah, we have some chat. Call of Duty, then chess, AlphaGo, Minecraft. Yeah, number of games are coming. Those are based on AI, artificial intelligence. Okay, so yeah, it is okay if you spend time to learn to spend time in games. Teachers normally support students for playing games. Okay, there are some cases where students are spending a lot of times for playing game, but there are cases where students has become expert. I have some of my students who used to play games with people from European countries. Okay, now he is talking like Europeans, so that is an advantage. No, his language has improved a lot. So when I talked to him, he was saying like his language improved after playing with Europeans, so his accent has changed. So that is an advantage. Okay, normally teachers, parents will complain he is playing games every day. Okay, but this is an advantage. Okay, if you play with people from outside the country, your language will improve. Okay, I'm talking about the case where you need conversation. Okay, multiple persons are involved and you form a team and play together. Okay, number of games are there. Okay, so there are advantages and as well as disadvantages. Whenever we talk about any applications or any system, keep thinking about only the advantages. Okay, so that is an advantage of playing games. So yeah, we will see these examples in the coming slides. Weather forecasting is a area where we need to invest more. Weather forecasting, nowadays we know, okay, most of the time it was raining. From June itself it was raining. Okay, we don't know any, we we have not passed without training. But is it possible for our government, weather forecasting agencies to predict that? According to me, they are not giving much information, prior information about weather. Okay, we are not prepared for that most of the time. So we need to put much effort in weather forecasting, and the machine learning can play a vital role in this area. Okay, some we already discussed and others we are going to see that. So I told about computer vision. Okay, computer vision is about deriving some meaningful information from images as well as video. Okay, we are deriving some information, meaningful information from images as well as video. You can find a GIF here as a GIF. GIF means graphical interchange format. And see, person, traffic light, okay, car. See this, what is it doing? It is identifying. It is identifying every object. So some algorithm is running on that. This algorithm identifies every object in this video and it try to recognize what the object is. Okay, this is a car. Car number, how many car? Person one, person two, person three, numbers are being displayed. Okay, traffic light. So it's trying to arrive at some meaningful information from images as well as video. So computer vision is a very large area where AI is mostly used. Some examples are like a facial recognition, augmented reality, and mixed reality. So this is another area of computer vision. So like classification. So if you are providing a set of images to a system for classification, so the system set of images include a cat, dog, maybe birds. So the system will classify all the images of cat. Here this includes classification as well as localization, means that object is being segmented. Where is that object? So initially localization happens, then only classification happens. Okay, this is an example of object detection. See, each object. See, there is a dog, there is a duck, there is a cat. There are three cats, okay? Another cat is here. So cat, dog, and duck. Each object is being detected. So this is a case of single object and this is a multiple object classification. Okay, so these are widely being used in computer vision and we find a lot of application. Okay, so AI is being used. Then comes to natural language processing. Now with the introduction of Alexa, okay, Google Assistant, everything is working on natural language processing. See, so this artificial intelligence is a very broader term. And under that, numerous areas are being discussed. So now the shadow of AI has become wider. And every day, everything is becoming smarter. And we are giving intelligence and new things are added under AI brand. So natural language processing is that helps to derive meaning from user text inputs. Okay, for example, we are giving this picture as input to a language processing system. Language processing system will give you the text. So this is a combination of text as well as image. Okay, so this natural language processing can take any inputs, like voice can be an input, image can be an input, and the output is a text. See, output is a text. So So natural language processing, about processing languages in any national language, Malayalam, English, or any other regional languages. Okay, so input can be anything. For example, can you tell any one application that is available in your mobile phone that performs natural language processing? Any application that is already installed in your mobile phone, I mean smartphone, that works based on natural language processing? Can someone tell me? You have a number of applications. Can someone tell me? Navaneet Krishna avade undo? Navaneet Krishna, Navaneet Krishna, Mohammed Faiz, Navaneet Krishna avade undo? Revathi, are you there? Revathi, Riswana PS, are you there? Riswana avade undo? Am I audible?
Yes ma'am, you're clear ma'am.
Ah, okay.
Audible. Dear students, please respond.
Are you there? Revathi avade undo? തെറ്റിന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ കുഴപ്പമൊന്നും ഇല്ല. ഓക്കെ, സം ആൻസർ ഇസ് ദയർ ഇൻ ചാറ്റ് ബോക്സ്. ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ, നവനീതനും രേവതിക്കും പ്രശ്നമുണ്ട്. ഓക്കെ, ഇറ്റ്സ് ഓക്കെ. റേസി പി എ, റേസി പി എ,
യെസ് മാം,
റേസി ആണോ? എൻ എൽ പി യൂസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ള ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു ആപ്ലിക്കേഷൻ നമ്മുടെ സ്മാർട്ട് ഫോണിൽ ഉള്ളതായിട്ട് അറിവുണ്ടോ? എനി ആപ്ലിക്കേഷൻ? ആർക്കെങ്കിലും അറിയുണ്ടോ?
ഇല്ല.
Ma'am, Google Assistant, Siri, Cortana.
Google Assistant uses, Google Assistant uses natural language processing. It understands our language, answer to that, okay. Then we can convert, earlier there was an application, a hardware device like a scanner was there. Okay, നിങ്ങൾ കണ്ടിട്ടുണ്ടാവില്ല. It was long back, before 15 years, okay, 10 years before that, there was a device like a scanner. Scanner means, scanner was used to scan documents, scan photograph. Cine ma'am narendao, okay.
Yes ma'am, yes.
Yes, scanner. So scanner, now there is no more scanners. അതിന്റെ പ്രൊഡക്ട്സ് ഇപ്പൊ സ്റ്റോപ്പ് ചെയ്ത്, ബിക്കോസ് ദർ ആർ ആപ്ലിക്കേഷൻസ് ദർ ആർ അവൈലബിൾ ഇൻ യുവർ മൊബൈൽ ഫോൺ,
ലൈക് അഡോബ് സ്കാൻ മാം.
യെസ്, അഡോബ് സ്കാൻ, മെനി അതർ സോഫ്റ്റ്വെയർസ് ആർ ദർ വേർ വി ക്യാൻ സ്കാൻ ഡോക്യുമെന്റ്സ് ഈസിലി. എന്താണ്, ഡസൻ്റ് റിക്വയർ ദ ഹെൽപ്പ് ഓഫ് എനി അതർ ഹാർഡ്വെയർ ഡിവൈസ്. ഓക്കെ, വി ക്യാൻ സ്കാൻ എ ഡോക്യുമെന്റ് വിത്ത് ദ ഹെൽപ്പ് ഓഫ് ദ ക്യാമറ അവൈലബിൾ ഇൻ അവർ മൊബൈൽ ഫോൺ. ഓക്കെ, and we can convert the text available in the document. Conversion of text also possible. So these all works with the help of natural language processing. Okay, Google Assistant is an example. Like this Google Scan, or Adobe Scan. Okay, they are all examples of natural language processing. It's possible to convert. It is possible to convert from one form to another. So these are some NLP applications. Spam detection. It's available as part of our Gmail. Spam mails are being filtered and moved to another folder. Then language detection, which language? Intelligent document processing. Now, instead of reading an entire newspaper or entire news content, okay, a brief news is available. Many applications for short news. Okay, intelligent document. So a document which is 1,000 words, 2,000 words, 5,000 words can be shortened to 50 words. Okay, understand entire content that was written in 5,000 words to 50 words. Document processing and arriving at some conclusion. We can arrive at some conclusion. Sentiment analysis. Okay, what the message is being conveyed? What's the sentiments behind the message? Then speech recognition. Okay, that was the most discussed and a hot topic in NLP. Questions answering, that is what the Google Assistant Alexa always performs. Text summarization, okay, that already informed. Machine translation. So here, from we move from bottom level to the topmost level, the hardness of the problem increases. Okay, these are some easy, and here we have some moderate complex tasks. And this is a task where complexity is more. Machine translation. Translation from Malayalam to English translation. See, we normally watch movies in Amazon Prime, YouTube. Okay. The subtitle that we see along with the movie is provided by the by the producer of the movie. Okay, whenever they produce subtitle, also it's being produced along with the movie and given to the OTT platforms, so we can play. So if it's possible to translate Malayalam to English, okay, we don't need a subtitle file along with that. So machine translation is something that is complex. Okay. So that's about natural language processing, and coming to artificial intelligence in healthcare. We are mostly getting benefited from the AI applications in healthcare as an aid in treatment. See, all the medical imaging modalities, okay, that comes under computer vision, like X-ray, CT, MRI, okay. So radiologists, okay, after taking the MRI, CT, they can arrive at some conclusions. But normally doctors also depend upon their conclusions, okay, for better diagnosis of any disease. Nowadays, we are mostly depending on artificial intelligence for efficient healthcare. Okay, then actually, it's possible to early detect any type of disease in that. So it helps in the improved decision making for any doctors. It's all these medical imaging modalities. And there are many application softwares that are being used by us, like for easy tracking of our health. Maybe if you are at the age of 40 or we will check sugar level, cholesterol level, okay, pressure level once in a month. Okay, we will keep on tracking. Now everyone have health smart watches with you. Health, okay. So it keeps on tracking your vitals. Okay, so this artificial intelligence is playing a vital role in the healthcare of everyone. There are different apps. Many apps are being used by people. So I remember, during my pregnancy, I used an app. Okay, that app keeps on giving us some indication about, okay, now your baby is 7 weeks old. Okay, 8 weeks old. your baby's weekly growth status now small. Okay, earbuds has developed. Okay, it has got small hands, legs. Okay, whenever we receive such messages, no. Okay, then whenever we enter some data, it keeps on giving us tips. So everything artificial intelligence will always try to make us happy and give us a better life. So you might also be using many applications in your area, and the only intention of such devices is to make you happy. Now coming to smart transportation. So some of you might be familiar with Uber. Okay, Uber, how Uber uses artificial intelligence. Okay, I think some of you might be familiar with Uber. Uber is a taxi service. We can book Uber from one place to another. So Kochi and all, it's available. I don't know, it is available in Thrissur. Okay, so Uber uses artificial intelligence, okay, for route optimization, to display the pool of Uber is a the pool of cars. Some taxis are available. So if you look at Uber, okay, it will display a set of taxis that are available in our proximity, okay, in our locality. And whenever we book an Uber from one place to another, okay, the nearest one will come to us and it will drop to our destination. Everything is online. We can pay money online. Okay, so these are the ways where Uber is using artificial intelligence. And this is Uber's first self-driving car. Okay, earlier we discussed about Tesla. Uber is also having a self-driving car. Okay, so you know what is the greatest specialty of computer science professionals? You are all about to learn computer science. Can someone tell me what is the greatest specialty of computer science professionals? Can someone tell me endayirikkum computer science inde oru pratheegatha endha nu ariyo ellarkkum? Mitra, are you there? Mitra evide undo? Mitra, Murali Shankar avade undo? Murali Shankar, njan chodikkuna kekkathano adho ningal on cheedittu poyekkuano? Murali Shankar kelkunnilla. Maria Joseph, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, Maria. Maria, where are you?
Kannur.
Ah, you are in a hostel? Yes. Okay. Maria, computer science, are you in a computer science? No. Okay, namukku computer science il namukku ariyam illo oth itrayum karyangal ella nadakkunnathu endana ipo computer science inde oru endana oru growth ee field namukku tharuna kore advantages okke undu, but nammal ee applications ellam use cheyyunnundu, but everything, every application has got a level of abstraction, alle hidden aanu. എന്താണ് ഉള്ളിൽ നടക്കുന്നതെന്ന് എന്താണ് മറ്റുള്ളവർക്ക് അത്ര മനസ്സിലാവില്ല, എസ്പെഷ്യലി പേഴ്സൺസ് ഫ്രം ഔട്ട്സൈഡ് ദ ഡൊമൈൻ. സി, നമ്മൾ ഈ സൂം മീറ്റിംഗിലാണ് നമ്മൾ എല്ലാവരും ഇൻട്രാക്ട് ചെയ്യുക, അല്ലെ? സൂമിൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എല്ലാവർക്കും ഇത് അറ്റൻഡ് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റുന്നുണ്ട്. യു ആർ സിറ്റിംഗ് ഇൻ ഫാർ അവേ പ്ലേസസ്, അല്ലെ? വെനവർ സീ ദ പ്ലാറ്റ്ഫോം, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് ഈ സൂമിന്റെ ഒരു ഡാഷ് ബോർഡ്, ഓക്കെ, ഈ ഒരു സ്ക്രീനിൽ നിന്ന് എന്താണ് എന്തൊക്കെയാണ് ഉള്ളിൽ നടക്കുന്നതെന്ന് ഒരു എന്താണ് ലേമാൻ പോയിന്റ് ഓഫ് വ്യൂല് വിസിബിൾ അല്ല, ആർക്കും മനസ്സിലാവില്ല, അല്ലെ? അത് തന്നെയാണ് കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ സയൻസിന്റെ ഏറ്റവും വലിയ പ്രത്യേകത. okay, the working, whatever be the working, if a Google Pay, if I want to transfer an amount of 1,000 to you, okay, in the symbol, pay. Pay in the button, press it, you're getting money. How simple? It's as simple as putting a button there. No, what are you doing? Pay, Google Pay, okay, authentication. Okay, checking whether enough balance exists in my account. Okay, whether your account is correct. It's getting transferred to your account. It's security, authenticity, everything is being checked. But it is hidden to the outside world. That is computer science in ettum illi pratheekada. Okay, see, namukariya IC engine use cheyidittana nammada car pravarthichondirna petrol engine, diesel engine. Okay, when it came to self-driving car, electric car, kudal features under, but it appears more cute alle mattinekkalum valare simple aitana id appear here. So that is a specialty of computer science. Endakke level of complication undengil it appears very simpler to the outside world. So that is the specialty of computer science. Okay, thank you, Maria. Okay, so computer science inde oru pratheegada adana, you should always keep it in mind. Okay, everything is made as simple as possible. It's presented as simple as possible to the customer. Okay, but initially or inside it is very complicated, but it's presented in the simplest way. Okay, so now, so this is Uber's self-driving car. Okay, all these are part of that. Okay, but it is simpler than an IC engine or car. Okay, so now it's about to stop about applications here, moving to the types of machine learning. So why I spend much time in applications? Because you should spend some time in reading, okay, and understanding the artificial intelligence in such devices. Then only you can create an interest in machine learning. If I start by explaining machine learning basics, you won't listen. So we are about to learn the different types of machine learning. There is supervised, unsupervised, and reinforced. Okay, so what is machine learning? It's a subset of artificial intelligence and focus on the ability of machines to receive data and learn for themselves without being programmed with rules. Okay, so what is the difference between the normal programming? So whenever you do programming, write a program to find the factorial of a number, find the Fibonacci series, sum of two numbers. Okay, there are a list of instructions. It works one after the other, okay? But in machine learning, we are allowing the program to self-learn, okay? We are asking the program to learn. That is the difference of machine learning. Now, these are the types of machine learning: supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement. We will see what are they. Supervised means learn from experiences. Experience means we are providing a data set. Okay, learn from the data set, learn from what is given in the data set. Okay, so we are given a data set, whether it will rain or not, okay, cloudy. Most of the day, it is cloudy, cloudy, cloudy. So there is a chance of rain. So learn from previous or past experience. Past experience is a set of data. Okay. So here we have input. This is the data set. We have working an algorithm. This algorithm is being trained to learn the logic, to learn the logic. Later, we will provide with fresh input. Okay. Fresh input. And it will provide the output. So that is supervised learning. Learning with a teacher. This teacher will tell how the algorithm should work. that is supervised learning. So supervised learning is divided into two types, classification and regression. These terms you may come across in your AI class, okay, classification and regression. So in terms of classification, output is a discrete value. Discrete value means it is classification, okay? Image classification. The discrete value can be a cat, a dog, and all, okay? In case of regression, okay, what is the probability that it rains on tomorrow? A continuous value probability. So 0.85. 0.85 is the answer of regression. Okay, output is a continuous value. Predicting stock price. Okay, I'm holding some stock. Okay, at present it is having 85 rupees per unit. What is the price after 1 year? Maybe 100. Using some formula, the system should be able to predict the price after 1 year. Gold price. Gold price. Okay. So regression is a type of predicting. Predicting. Okay. It gives a continuous value, whereas classification gives a discrete value. It can be any classes like cat, dog, etc. If it is a Gmail classifies every email coming. Some are classified in the inbox category. Some are in social promotions and spam. Give me a minute. I will continue. Give me a minute. So sorry for that. Okay, we will continue. So supervised learning is divided into classification and regression. So this is an example. Madam, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here is a data set. I told you in the case of classification, we are learning from past experience. Okay, here is a data set of shopping site. Okay, this is a user ID and whether that person belongs to, okay, which category, gender of the person, age of the person, and his monthly salary. So with this data, the system is predicting whether the person will purchase a certain item or not. Zero means we are getting a discrete value, zero on five. Okay, not purchase or purchase. Okay, so the system is classifying the category of person. Maybe sometimes it is a costly item. So whether the person having user ID 1580402 will purchase an item? Yes. Okay, here he has got a better salary. Maybe based on the salary only they are arriving at a conclusion. Okay. So here is an example of regression. We told it based on, this is a meteorological data set that serves the purpose of predicting wind speed. Wind speed. So we have temperature, pressure, relative humidity, and wind direction. Based on that, there might be an equation for predicting wind speed. Okay. So we can predict wind speed. This is a continuous value. So this is the difference between classification and regression. So I hope it is clear for you. These are the two types of supervised learning. Okay. And these are some popular algorithms in supervised learning. Linear regression, nearest neighbor, decision trees, support vector machine, random forest. Okay, this includes regression as well as classification tasks. Now coming to unsupervised. Okay, unsupervised, I told, okay. It's learning without a teacher. Learning without a teacher. Okay, I will show you an example. Here, okay, we have a collection of land, water, and air. Okay, cat is there. Okay, then some birds are there, some fish, whale. Okay, so cat comes under land animal, birds come under air animals, okay, and water animals. So this is a collection. So based on some properties, okay, unsupervised learning will group the element into three categories. So this is air animals, this is water animals, and this is land animals. So this is a type of clustering, a type of clustering where animals are being are divided into groups. So that is clustering. It's an unsupervised. So it's very different from the example that we learned earlier. Okay. So what is unsupervised? Describes a class of problem that involves using a model to describe or extract relationship. So there will be a mathematical model, and based on the mathematical model, it will explore the relationship between elements in a set. Okay. And the famous algorithm that is available in unsupervised is clustering. K means clustering and KNN clustering are the popular algorithms. Then comes about the reinforcement learning. So we will see an example. It's a game. Okay, here is a robot and here's fire and a diamond. The robot, we should move this robot so that it will take this diamond. It's a reward. Okay, it's a reward. So during the journey, it should not touch fire. So it should choose some other path. So what reinforcement learning will check is that it will analyze maybe some other place also this diamond is placed. It will check, the reinforcement algorithm will check all possible paths and it will provide you the best path that can reach at the reward. Okay. So whenever you cross a fire, you will lose the reward. So at present, if it is a game, at present you have some points. If you cross a fire, you will lose some points. Okay. If you reach the diamond, you will get some points. So this algorithm will make a walkthrough through all possible routes and will reach the destination. So that is reinforced. It's about taking suitable action to maximize reward in a particular situation. Okay, like we are at a certain point. Okay, we should reach the destination. All possible ways we will, best one we will choose. That is reinforcement learning. So these algorithms, you know, these algorithms are always being used by human to come make some decisions. Now coming to deep learning. So deep learning is quite different. I told you here, learning is made in such a way, okay, just like how human brains think and make some decisions. So it comes under, okay, comes under machine learning only. Okay, in machine learning, some sort of algorithms uses neural networks. Okay, but deep learning uses multi-layered neural network that can learn, self-learn from the amount of data. So the main difference between machine learning and deep learning is that in machine learning, the system is learning from some parameters, or we can say features. We can say features, okay? For example, in this case, okay, classification, this is gender is a feature, age is a feature, salary is a feature, and we are providing a very small data set, okay? This we can say a feature. But when it comes to deep learning, okay, we are providing a very broad, very large data set, and we are not exactly giving the feature along. Okay, a large data set we are providing, and from that it was self-learn. It was self-learn. If it is an image, if it is a computer vision task for deep learning algorithms, okay, we will provide the image as set as such as input. But if it is a machine learning algorithm will try to take the features. I can better explain with the help of a small example in case of face recognition. Face recognition, machine learning algorithms normally face recognition features see the place of our iris, our nose tip, our lips. Okay, but deep learning will recognize face based on many other. Maybe it may take the distance between our iris and nose tip. It will get it multiplied. We don't know what is happening inside the multi-layer neural network. It will understand in a different way. Maybe it will multiply the distance between iris and nose tip 100 times, yet it's divided by some other value, length of the lips. Okay, this being understood in a different way. So deep learning algorithms, because of their multi-layered neural network structure, it can think and behave in a different way. See this? We are providing features for classification in the case of machine learning. But in the case of deep learning, okay, input is provided as such. Features, feature extraction and classifications are performed by this multi-layer neural network as such. So here, based on the feature, we are providing only features. So feature extraction is a part of machine learning. But in case of deep learning, this feature extraction is not a part, it's performed self, okay? So here the output is same, okay? So as the system is alone learning the features, the accuracy is more in the case of deep learning. Okay, so that is, here you can compare the performance that as the size of data increases, okay? See, the traditional machine learning, the traditional machine learning performance, okay, then coming to small neural networks and coming to deep learning, large neural networks, see, provides better performance for large data set. Okay, see how the performance is being increased. Okay. Now I will give you an insight about how to start learning machine learning. So that's all about the types of machine learning. Now, how can you start learning machine learning by yourself? Okay, there are some prerequisites for learning machine. First is mathematics. Mathematics includes linear algebra, multivariate calculus, probability and statistics. Must. It's a must for learning machine learning. See, we only discussed about applications. We haven't gone through any mathematics behind the working of any of the algorithm. Okay, so this learning this mathematics is must. Then for implementation, okay, for design and understanding you require mathematics, but for programming, so you must have an awareness about all these packages, NumPy, Pandas, scikit-learn, matplotlib. Like these are some important libraries available in Python, so you must learn them. Okay, so I have provided some free learning sources how to learn all these mathematics. I will share the link, okay, or I will provide the PPT as such. So you can, the link is provided here. So these are some free learning sources of mathematics I provided earlier. Then this Python, okay, and basics, okay. So you must spend some time to learn machine learning. Oh, and coming to the conclusion, okay, I don't know, as you are all first year students, see, my intention was only to create an understanding about machine learning, okay? See, you all must know what is machine learning, okay? Maybe as computer science professional, you may go into work with machine learning algorithms. So the first method to learn machine learning is to start learning from the scratch. Okay, you must learn mathematics. You must learn Python. Okay, you must learn the basics of machine learning. Okay, then you can build small application level programs in machine learning. And once you are expert in solving small machine learning programs, you can start building bigger projects of machine learning. Okay, and you can definitely conquer the world of machine learning. Okay, so that's all about the technical session. Thank you. Thank you for listening. And if you have any queries, if you have any queries, you can ask now.
Dear students, do you have any queries? Hope the session was fine and clear to all. That's why they don't have any queries, I guess, ma'am. Ma'am, shall I ask one?
Yeah, sure, ma'am.
Yeah. Ma'am, do we have any authorized site to get the data set for ML?
Are you aware about Kaggle?
Yes. Yeah, ma'am, I have heard about it.
Yeah, most of the data set our students are taking from Kaggle.
Kaggle.
And Google, no? Google AI. Google also help us to learn about machine learning. So if you search Google AI, you will get a set of free courseware.
Okay.
And they have also provided link. What Google want is they want everyone us to learn machine learning.
Exactly.
Google want all of us to learn machine learning. They are also providing much help for understanding machine learning. Okay. So it's available. Kaggle is K-A-G-G-L-E.
Yeah. Okay, ma'am.
Most of the data sets you can download from there.
Okay.
And whenever we start work on a project, the first step is to check whether the data set exists or not.
Exactly.
Okay. Some problems might be very much interesting. If data set is not available, don't go behind that problem.
Okay.
Even if it is a machine learning problem or a deep learning, it's not possible to see it's not possible to construct a data set for deep learning by ourselves during our research life. Okay. Or even for a PG or a UG student. So whenever you start doing a project, first step is to make sure that data set exists.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. So any queries from the audience? Okay, that's done. Thank you so much, ma'am, for the informative and very interesting session. Since majority of our audience is first year, so we have first year UG and first year PG in our session. So you have given so much of better ideas to do their projects, term paper presentation, and so on. So thank you so much, ma'am. To conclude, let me welcome our HOD, Ms. Viji Vishwanathan, to render the vote of thanks. Would you miss?
Thank you, seniors. Hope I am Mr. Blend audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Good morning, everyone. I am here to present the vote of thanks for today's webinar, Machine Learning for Beginners. Artificial intelligence became the most important part of our daily life. Our life is changed by AI because of this technology. It is used in a wide area of our daily life. By celebrating Computer Literacy Week, our motive is to make familiar the new technologies which have immense role in daily life. I want to express my sincere gratitude to our resource person, Dr. Rimya K. Shashi, who has paid her precious time from to grace the occasion and enlighten all of us with the ideas of the applications of AI and what is machine learning and the difference between the machine learning and deep learning through this webinar. Thank you, ma'am. I would also like to thank our principal, Reverend Dr. Jolie Andrews, in his absence. Thank you, Father. And now I want to thank our director, Father Dr. Wilson Tharel, who present here to inaugurate and bless our webinar. Thank you, Father. I would like to thank our IQC coordinator, Dr. Robinson P. Parmenisseri. Thank you, sir. And our teachers and students who present here to attend this webinar. And I want to thank Ms. Sinit Thomas and Ms. Vasha Ganesh, who are the coordinators of this event. Thank you, everyone, for actively participate in this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much. Yeah. So by this, we come to the end of our first day session of Computer Literacy Week. So once again, I thank on behalf of our department to all who made this event happen. Participants, please fill the feedback form before you leave. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am, for the opportunity.
Yeah, thank you so much, ma'am. Welcome.
Recording stopped.
Students, please fill the feedback form.